friends, Sonic Toast here, running a promotion with Entertainment Earth, one of the biggest toy retailers out there. And right now, you can get 10% off any in-stock item on their site by using the URL ee.toys/toast. Now on with the video. Greetings friends, Sonic Toast here, and in previous videos, we somewhat randomly opened up three of these Paradox Prism capsule items that you can get at Walmart. And in these previous videos, we saw Shadow, we saw Sonic, like the Pirate Boots Sonic, and Sails from the Pirate Dimension also. And they were really cool. Anyway, I did find some more at my local Walmart. And to my surprise, they were, where is it? On sale, here it is. They were $1.24 off, making them $3.73 each. And I do have to give a big thank you to everybody who commented that you can so easily slip off the cardboard, check which one is inside, and slip the cardboard back on. So I did that for these four new ones that I got. So I actually already know which ones are in there. Of course, that was like 2 weeks ago that I did it, and I haven't had time to do a video about it until now, so I don't remember which is which, but I do know they are all new ones. So let's go ahead. We will open these up and see what's inside and look at each character. Toast. All right, so as we open up the first one, we have a stand, and it's a Tails. It is, what's he called? Like Mangy Tails or something like that. So that is cool. Let's go ahead and just set him aside for now and move on to the next one. All right, opening the next one, and this one is the Boss Gage Maze Sonic, who also comes with a Prism Shard and a stand. All right, well, Tails here. Actually, I really like the sculpt on this figure. I think the sculpt is great. The paint is a little bit of an issue, as it does look a little sloppy in parts, and there's not a lot of color detail, especially on his shoes and stuff. But overall, I think it is pretty good. I mean, it's not as badly noticeable as like Shadow shoes. For the most part, yeah, I think this figure is just fine, and I like how he looks. Now, the Boss Gage Maze Sonic has similar issues, although they did paint some details on his gloves and his shoes, which I do like. Not all the details, but some, which is good. The shard looks good also. He's got kind of a weird pose, though. The way he's reaching out, all like trying to reach something. Yeah, this one just seems a little strange to me. Not as crazy about it, but oh well. All right, moving on to number three. Let's see who is in here. It is none other than, oh, we got Rusty Rose. Is this the only one from New York City that we got in this set? Maybe there'll be a wave two with more, but yeah, I think everyone else is from Boss Gage Maze and the No Land or whatever it was called, the Ocean Place, and then Shadow from the Prime Dimension or whatever they call it. So yeah, this is the only one, which I actually admire, because I feel like they're giving a lot of attention to New York City, especially with Dine and Sonic in his New York City shoes. So, you know, it's cool they're saving some of those for Wave 2, if they do a Wave 2. All right, and the last one for today is none other than, all right, it is Knuckles. Yeah, Knuckles. Oh my gosh, his teeth. Oh, why didn't they paint his teeth in? That's terrible. All right, wait a second. This one has no stand. It has the shard, but no stand. Oh man. So Rusty Rose has a lot of detail sculpted into her, but again, the paint job's just not there. Paint looks very plain. It feels like these are almost like for those hardcore collectors who can do like the Dungeons and Dragons type painting of miniatures and go through and paint these like really detailed and make them look nice, because as they are, they don't look that nice. Sculpt wise, they look great. It's the paint that's the problem. Overall, kind of a cool figure. It's too bad they did not have Thorn Rose at Walmart when I went, so that's the only one that I'm missing now. But oh well, maybe someday. And here is Knuckles. It is quite unfortunate he didn't come with a stand. even more unfortunate is the paint job on this figure. This is like the worst one of them all. Look at his shoes, look at his gloves, look at his vest, look at his dreadlocks on the back. I think the biggest offender of all though is his teeth. This one just looks terrible. Oh man, awful. Oh well though, oh well. And it's unfortunate that I didn't get a stand with it, but he stands pretty well on his own. And he can't borrow someone else's stand, as each stand is made specifically for the character that it comes with. And also I'd like to point out, like, look at this, at the holes on his feet. He's got one little hole on his right foot and a big hole on his left foot. So like, you can't just stick them on the stands and whatever pegs you want on the stand. You have to stick them on specific pegs, which is kind of interesting. All right, and here is my carousel of all the characters that I have collected so far. This is 7 out of the 8 that they make. And honestly, I enjoy collecting these now that I know that you can pick which character you are getting, and I'm hoping that they do more. I'd love to have a complete set of the Pirates, a complete set of the Boss Cage Maze characters, you know, stuff like that. And I do think that the three Pirates here, Sails and Sonic and Captain Dread Knuckles, they do look kind of charming together, all in their little outfits. So that is really fun. Not the highest quality, but you know, they're here. If I had these when I was in third grade, I would have been flipping out, because anything Sonic, I'm grateful for. Anyway, friends, thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments section if you are collecting these or what you think of them. Are they too cheap for you, too lame looking, or do you think they're cool like I do? Have a fantastic day and toast.